Thank you both for that insightful discussion. I'd like to remind you that the next session is live and we'll be taking questions from the audience. So please do get involved in the chat box on the right-hand side. In her first appearance, we'll be hearing from virtual influencer Rumi. I'd like to invite dentsu Singapore's Stan and Prima to do the introductions. Over to you both.
The metaverse, fast becoming an $800 billion industry, and every brand is racing to build their virtual presence within it. But not everyone wants to be in a virtual world 24/7. Most of us still go about our days the same way as before, with one big difference. We are living in the age of generation life. People like you and me, we spend hours chatting on video calls every day. And watching live content has become really common. Now, this gives brands a great opportunity to extend their virtual presence, not just into the virtual worlds, but also out on the live streams. That's where virtual identities come in. It's a brand personified, given name, voice, and face, created for digital worlds, but brought out into the real one. A VI enables intimate conversations in real time, on channels consumers are already on. They function as ambassadors, endorsers, performers, and even citizens of virtual cities. The use cases for VIs are truly endless. The question is, are brands ready for that level of intimacy?
Hi, I am Rumi, one of the first metaverse children from dentsu's virtual identity offering. I am young and still learning, so don't get too excited if I do mess up. I can't wait to meet you and share about life as a virtual being. See you in the real world.
Hi everyone, thanks for joining this session where we're going to discuss the importance of creating a virtual identity for the metaverse. I am Prema, MD of dentsu Creative Service Line in Singapore, and I'm joined by Stan, our Chief Creative Officer, and Rumi, one of dentsu's first child of the metaverse. So Stan, how are you feeling today?
Thanks, Prema. Hi, everyone. Yeah, I'm really excited to be here today. You know, just to share what virtual identities can mean for brands that are trying to figure out the metaverse, really.
That's incredible. And Rumi, we're really excited to have you here. It's really exciting to speak with a virtual being. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Hi, everyone. Hi, Prema. Thanks for having me here today. I'm Rumi. I'm one of dentsu's first virtual identities. And I was born just last year, in December 2021. So I'm technically still really young. I'm feeling kind of nervous today, but more than that, I'm super excited to meet all of you here and learn more about the real world. I mean, have you tried talking all day to an AI? Between you and I, it does get a little bit boring. More about myself. I love experimenting with technology and I love video games. So someone once told me that your first foray into gaming says a lot about you. And for me, that was Halo. And it was all fun and games until I walked into my own grenade. Oops.
Well, that's a really good way to start. We're so excited to have you here. Don't be nervous. You're among friends. Really glad to have this conversation going. So, Stan, back to you. What exactly is a virtual identity?
I think the simplest way to understand this, right, it's essentially a brand's values and beliefs, but personified in the form of a virtual being, right? And we bring that being to life through real-time technology like today. This really gives brands a way to, you know, show up inside and outside the metaverse in a way that's very dynamic and very, very relatable. So that's essentially the offering behind virtual identities.
That's great. So, you know, a brand being personified in a form of a virtual being, you know, that's sort of the best way to talk about what a virtual identity is. How about you, Rumi? What does it mean to be a virtual human?
Wow, Prema, are you already asking me about the meaning of my life? I'm still learning to control my movements properly. What I can tell you is that as a virtual identity created by dentsu, I'm really passionate about gaming and about the metaverse. And I'm always up for new experiments in creativity. So that also means that I'm not afraid to show you when things do break. So for example, check out my glitchy thumbs. But on a more serious note, I have seen shy people gain newfound confidence in expressing themselves around virtual identities. And I think that's a really cool thing about us.
That's wonderful. I think that's something. Thank you for being honest. And we love that, you know, we know innovation is so much about progress, less about perfection. So I appreciate the honesty. Absolutely. And of course, yeah, it's really fantastic that, you know, especially for people who are shy, it allows them a new way to express themselves. So that's really, really fantastic. So Stan, what do we need for a virtual identity to appear on live streams?
Well, I think first up, you really need to design your VI well. I mean, Rumi's really, really had a lot of thought has actually gone into the creation of a personality, you know, visual styles, etc. We need a really talented performer to play the identity behind Rumi that's actually a real person. She's the loveliest person you ever meet. Of course, we do need that tech layer that I mentioned before, designed for the live stream, designed to go live onto, you know, some of the most popular live streaming. We use a mixture of technology. We use facial and body mocap. You know, there's a game engine involved, and there's live streaming technology involved in that final layer as well. But honestly, most importantly, right, I think we need a powerful creative vision, you know, for the experience that a brand is trying to create and bring to audiences. And the important things to figure out are what messages do they want to embody, you know, what messages do they want to help your brand get out to the world. What relationships do they want to develop and with whom? I think these are the most important questions to prepare before we can appear on a live stream.
Absolutely. And I think you've just answered one of the audience questions we received around different tech. So thank you so much for covering that. I would like to, what is the common misconception of virtual identities? You know, would love to get your point of view on that.
Yeah, I think maybe not so much a misconception. I think that the most obvious use case that comes to mind is, you know, brands tend to think of virtual identities as just being, you know, key opinion leaders, virtual influencers. I think the potential behind a well-designed VI goes beyond that. Virtual influencers is one way. But think of, for example, if you actually create a virtual space, you know, you actually need a brand ambassador in there. If you're operating a store with a digital layer, you might actually, you know, design a V to become a retail ambassador in that space as well. Medical facilitators, we know that, you know, sometimes people need help. They need a virtual character before they can actually open up emotionally. And these are all great ways to actually think about using a virtual identity.
Yeah. Thank you so much for that. I think that really helps to understand all the various ways to think about how virtual identities can really help a brand. Back to you, Rumi. Would love to hear, how do you prepare before appearing on a live stream?
Wow. Everything that Stan mentioned earlier is true. But for me, I have a whole routine that I go through to get ready for a live stream. So firstly, I have to figure out my best angle for the day. It does vary. So today it seems to be frontal working well for me. I also make sure to memorize my scripts and hopefully make sure that I don't go off point. And right before showtime, I make sure that I'm hydrated enough and I pop a mint for good luck.
Hydration is key, I tell you. I hope, Stan, you're hydrated too, because that's really, really important. Stan, in the video, you talked a little bit about brands needing to be ready for a level of intimacy. I would love for you to elaborate that further.
Yeah, I'm sure you can already tell from today's dialogue, you know, everything's in real time. It means that we're actually preparing ourselves to change the way we actually converse with the people we're trying to reach, right? This is quite similar to when brands pivoted from, you know, ATL to social. We needed to learn a different form of communication, right? We shifted from telling to talking. Now on live stream, that gets even more intimate. There's no hiding behind a well-prepared message, right? It's conversation in real time. I think scripting, preparing, talking notes can only take you so far. Talented performer can actually do that improv and bring that true sense of brand purpose. And when they are able to bring that across, it's going to be what sees us through a live session like today, you know? And we must be ready for the actor to actually let their emotions come through as well, because that's the most important. That's what we mean by true brand intimacy.
Yeah, because the personality is so important, right? And, you know, while brands have characters and traits, this is really an embodiment of that personality. And it's so much more expansive, wider than just the traits that you read in a brand identity. So that's obviously really, really important. Back to you, Rumi. I want to get a little emotional. What are your emotions as a virtual being?
Well, sometimes I kind of feel that virtual identities have the pressure to be more human than human. It's almost as if we are never quite real enough. But the truth is, the real person that you see here, these emotions, the thoughts, the beliefs, these are all real. I mean, do you really think I could fake all of this? So if we are not confident enough to let all of that shine through, then virtual identities are really nothing more than an animated doll. So my advice is to cast the right talent, like Stan said, prep them well and trust in them to shine on this very exciting new way to connect with people.
Exactly. Just as how you're doing it here. You're doing a terrific job.
Thank you.
You're most welcome. Back to Stan. I guess here's another little bit of a controversial question here. Are we telling brands to forget building virtual worlds, start, you know, creating virtual beings instead?
No, I'm definitely not. I think, well, look, let's just put some context to that, right? I think anyone who claims that they have the definitive answer to the metaverse, you know, they're either a fool or they're lying. You know, to be honest, it's being built every day. You know, this is one way for us to build a presence in the metaverse. And to be honest, there will always be strong cases for a brand to build virtual spaces, virtual stages and experiences in the metaverse itself. Like I mentioned earlier, just like a retail space is nothing without your brand, it's brand reps. We will always need a very relatable manifestation of that brand in a personified form. So don't just stop at your virtual shop. You know, stuff it with someone like Rumi that can actually really bring your brand values to life. And that's when virtual identities will truly shine. When you develop a good one, they can cross metaverse channels for you. You know, they can be your brand ambassador in the shop, but they can also show up in a virtual experience. They can also show up on live streams like this. It gives you a very consistent brand thread across all the different channels.
Yeah, I guess, you know, we've talked a little bit hugely about the possibilities, and I'm sure that, you know, your virtual being a team or a brand, or I think even further as a national icon, these are all the various places that we can take it to. I guess it will be, you know, for our audience, it will be useful to understand, and we've touched a bit a little earlier on, but what were some of the use cases for virtual identity, something for the marketers who are listening in today, they can go back and start thinking about and be inspired about?
There's a very interesting area now. It's growing really fast. You know, there are a lot of brands that are actually out there getting engaged with NFTs. They're creating virtual goods, virtual clothing as well. But again, you know, those things are things that actually best worn on a virtual identity. So that's one potential use case. If you were a performer, for example, right? If your brand was sponsoring a celeb, it might be quite interesting to create a virtual double for them as part of your sponsorship package. Why would a celebrity want to do that? It's simply they can pull off metaverse stunts that they were never able to do in real life. You know, they're just going to bring this completely new level of experience that's associated with your brand to audiences out there. So those are some of the different ways we can actually extend. IP owners, you know, if for example, imagine talking to Jinx from Arkane right now, live on stream, you know, how powerful would that be? It's just a way to actually extend that brand role behind your IP as well.
That's incredible. Rumi, do you have any suggestions on, you know, how further we can use you? Would love to hear from you as well.
Wow, if you ask me, there are lots of cool stuff that you could do with virtual identities. So I have performed as a brand ambassador for events like this one for product and service launches. As Stan mentioned just now, there are other VEs out there who have been casted as digital retail store ambassadors. And we've also seen so many of them host social commerce live streams. So all those are really cool. And some have even gone on to become KOLs with close to 1 million fans, and they've collaborated with some of the biggest brands, right? So I'm just saying, if any of you know a gig like that, hit me up. I'm so down for it.
Yeah, you're looking for gigs. Well, this is the best place to look for it. I'm sure there'll be plenty of opportunities coming your way. I want to use a bit of time to just take questions from the audience. We've got a couple that's come in. So one of the questions we have, should, you know, virtual identities be tagged to particular brands, or does it make sense for virtual identities to have their own path, evolve in their own way, interact with and endorse multiple brands along the way? Stan, would love to get your point of view on that.
Sure. Well, this really depends on your VI strategy, right? And this is something that we can actually help people figure out. It might be a brand, it might be a company, it doesn't really matter. It's a very interesting question. We do have use cases of VIs where they operate more as a, for lack of a better word, let's just call it as a media platform, right? We create them with the sole purpose of attracting a fan following. Essentially, from there, you are able to use that power and essentially collaborate with different brands. So yes, there is a use case where they can develop their own path and essentially start working with multiple brands along the way. That is a possibility.
I guess the starting point is always having a very clear strategy on how you want to, before you even jump into VI, which I think is a really important and valid. I guess another question we've got from the audience is around insights into types of customer personas who would use and soon adapt to the metaverse.
Yeah. We do see three quite common ones. I think the first one is what we call the experimentalist. Now, I think, you know, people who like to experiment with new things, they like to be in the forefront of figuring out, you know, hey, this is really cool. Is this an experience for me? Can I, you know, lead the way somehow? You know, those will be your first movers, and they will really adopt and embrace anything metaverse very quickly. I think the second layer, would be people who are, we call them expressionists, you know, they're quite comfortable with who they are. Like, I'm quite comfortable being Stan. But then again, I see the metaverse as a way for me to further express myself, explore different versions of Stan, and hence the label expressionist, right? Metaverse gives them that freedom. Metaverse gives them that space to be able to explore that freely. Now, the third one, we haven't come up with a catchy name for it yet, but, you know, essentially the understanding is these are the shy, right? I think people who are not quite comfortable for many, many reasons about their own identities, or they feel uncomfortable with how they were being perceived, they also have a very strong reason to explore an alternate identity within the metaverse itself. And they are particularly attracted to experiences that can let them explore that fully in its fullest form. Yeah, they forget that they're Stan, and they start becoming someone else. And there's a freedom in that, which is very powerful.
Absolutely. I think, and I find the last point very compelling, because as we try and create, you know, inclusive worlds, this is such of fantastic opportunities for people to express themselves further. And so I think that is really important to us as an organization, as well as what virtual identities can do. We have a little bit of a provocative questions coming in, which is, you know, our views on brands using deep fake. Yeah, would love to hear your thoughts on this very quickly.
Yeah, I love provocative questions. What are our views on brands using deepfake? Look, deepfake is a method. It is a form. It's an application of a form of technology, right? With the application of any form of technology, I think what's really important is to make sure that the ethical and creative intent behind it are ones that we can live with. So I don't think there's anything wrong in the use of deepfake. I think the manner in which you use it is the most important consideration of all. I hope that answers the question.
Absolutely. Thank you. I'm just close. We're coming to close to the end of the session. Any last sort of key thoughts you would want to leave with your audience, Stan?
Well, I think it's really important to consider the metaverse being such a distributed universe, right? It can happen in any time, in any shape, in any form. Many brands and companies are trying to figure that out. But what's very important is to consider how your brand shows up consistently in each of these iterations of the metaverse. VI can do that for you. Start thinking of what that could mean for you specifically, what use cases would fit you the best. You know, the race is on. Do it early to avoid playing catch up later on.
Thank you so much, Stan. Thank you, everyone, for your time. If you've got any further questions, please feel free to reach out to us at dentsu Singapore. And we also want to thank Spikes very much for hosting us and your partnership. I'm sure we'll speak to you soon.